Ladymatic presents Leading Women.
In one of the world's largest cities, the footprint of the world's second biggest car company, General Motors. The U.S. automaker is once again solvent after nearly going under in 2009. Back then, this executive was also feeling the pain of the crisis gripping the company.
What was it like to face that enormous problem?
It was daunting to start.
She ultimately weathered the economic storm.
Let's check on that. Yeah.
Lieblein seems tailor-made for her job, a Latina who's at ease leading her team, walking the plant, or celebrating a new launch. In a 30-year-plus career at GM, she's gone from trainee to president. Her journey began when she was 18. Her passion for the brand even earlier.
My father worked for General Motors as well. I mean, I think I have gas in my veins.
The driving force behind General Motors in Brazil is Grace Lieblein. São Paulo's commercial centers, upscale shops, and vibrant nightlife make the city attractive. With all that, also comes its notorious traffic jams. 1,000 new cars hit the roads every day in São Paulo, among them GM cars. Grace Lieblein is in charge of GM's Brazil operation, overseeing a workforce of more than 23,000. It's shortly after 8 a.m., and Lieblein is leaving for work.
Fill the bank.
Her driver and security by her side. The day's busy agenda starts in the car.
Pretty much take the whole ride into work, about 40 minutes catching up on emails before I hit my office, which is a great way to start the day.
She's heading to Sacatano do Sul, where GM Brazil is headquartered. Lieblein sets the strategic direction of the business, drives production and sales, to name just a few of the hats that she wears as president.
Bom dia.
Tell me what it's like to work in the auto industry. I mean, this is traditionally thought of as a male-dominated arena.
Right.
But yet here is a woman who's taken over Brazil.
You know, my mom instilled in me a belief that I could do anything. And so the interesting thing was when I decided to go into engineering and into the auto industry, it didn't feel odd to me.
On her docket this day, a launch celebration for the revamped Chevy Cobalt and recognition for a group of employees. There's also a meeting with top managers about an upcoming auto show.
So we'll have one Cobalt or two?
We're going to have one.
Before coming to Brazil last year to run the operation, Lieblein was president and managing director of GM Mexico, the first woman to serve in that role.
I arrived in Mexico in January 2009. The global financial crisis occurred. GM was on the brink.
That couldn't have been easy to go through.
No. GM was on the brink of bankruptcy.
Exactly. Government bailout.
Right. Yeah, exactly. And, you know, pretty much in Mexico, we were, you know, sort of on our own. We had to stay liquid ourselves.
So what's different about being a leader during times of crisis versus times of recovery?
It's sometimes easier in times of crisis, because in times of crisis, there's something to rally around. People understand that there's urgency.
Fast forward to today. GM may have survived the financial meltdown, but the company's economic picture is not all that rosy.
So 2013, I think we're going to have stronger growth, not, you know, the 8-9% growth that this market has seen in the past, but you know, respectable growth.
In the coming weeks, find out more about Lieblein's work as we reveal a future model.
What I'm going to do with this.
Her life in Brazil and some important lessons she's learned.
You know, one of the things that I always tell women is believe in yourself. You know, if you don't believe in yourself, it's going to be really hard to get others to believe in you.
Omega Ladymatic presents Leading Women.